Hello everyone, this is Dennis and you are on the Den Electro channel. Today we will talk about computer power supplies. About what voltages are there and what else can be obtained. I am sure many people know that the ATX power supply produces several different voltages. 3, 5 and 12 volts. There are also lines for minus 5 and minus 12 volts, but fewer people know about this. The positive lines are powerful, you can extract several dozen amperes from them. But the negative lines are weaker, the current there is usually from 0.5 to 1 ampere. All these voltages are common in everyday life, but sometimes you need to get some other voltage. Say 1.5, 9, 10 or 15 volts. And it seems as if a computer power supply will not help here. You will either need some other current source, or the power supply will need to be significantly modified to get some other voltages. But in fact, an ATX computer power supply is not as simple as it seems. There are still many different voltages. You just need to find them. Additional, non-standard voltages can be obtained in a very simple way. The secret is that all these voltages are the terminals of one secondary winding of the transformer. If you take the positive probe of the multimeter and connect it to the plus 5 volt line, and connect the negative probe of the multimeter to the plus 3 volt line, you can get about 1.5 volts. But between the plus 5 and plus 12 terminals there are already more turns. Therefore, the voltage between them will be higher. Here it is almost 7 volts. Between the plus 12 and plus 3 volts terminals there are about 8.5 volts. Well, you can see all the other voltages on your screens. Keep in mind that the accuracy of this voltage will vary slightly on different power supplies. It can also change when other lines of the power supply are loaded. It can become either slightly higher or slightly lower. Please note that I did these red and blue lines for a reason. The red line means plus or the positive probe of the multimeter. And the blue one means minus. The negative probe of the multimeter. So we will take the negative from this output. Now I will test some of these lines and show what load can be removed from them. All these voltages can be taken from the ATX connector. I will connect it. In order to turn on the power supply, you need to short circuit the phosphorus monosulfide on contacts and ground. For this, you can make a jumper from the wire. First, I will start with low voltage. Measurement between 3 volts and 5. I connected the positive probe of the multimeter to 5 volts, and the negative to 3. This multimeter will show voltage, and this one will show load current. I will use two resistors as a load. First, I connect one. Current 30 milliamps, voltage dropped just a little. Now the second, current 60 milliamps, voltage has hardly changed. Now I'll take another resistor, with a lower resistance. The current is 230 milliamps, but the voltage has dropped to 1.1 volts. As you can see, the voltage on this line is very unstable and changes greatly under the influence of the load. But it can easily handle something low power. In the form of LEDs, some thermometers are watches that are powered by a voltage of 1.5 volts. You can even charge nickel-cadmium batteries. Now I'll look between the plus 12 and plus 5 volt lines. The voltage here is 6.8 volts. When connecting a small cooler from a computer, the voltage sags a little. The current is 60 milliamps. I'll disconnect this fan and try to connect a larger cooler. The voltage immediately dropped, the power supply went into overload protection. I pull out the jumper and start the power supply again. I'll try to load the 5-volt line with a resistor and see if anything changes. After connecting it, the voltage increased by about 15 millivolts. I connect a small cooler, the voltage dropped a little less than last time, only by 10 millivolts. I connect a large fan. Now it started and the power supply did not turn off. I connect the second fan and everything is fine, nothing turns off. The current is 220 milliamps and the voltage has hardly dropped. As you can see, if you load the 5-volt line with some kind of load, the power supply works more stably. The voltage drops less and the power supply does not go into protection. Now let's see what happens between the plus 12 and plus 3-volt lines. The voltage between them is about 8.5 volts. I connect a small fan, the voltage dropped by 10 millivolts. The current is 70 milliamps. I disconnect it and try to connect a large fan. The power supply turns off again. I connect a resistor to the 5-volt line and restart the power supply. The voltage increased by about 15 millivolts. But after connecting the fan, it sags more than before. I disconnect the small fan. Connect the large one and the power supply turns off. As you already understood, even with a resistor connected to the 5-volt line, the power supply still cannot pull a large cooler at this voltage. This line is also only good for low loads. Now let's connect minus 12 and plus 3 volts. There will be 15 volts between them. I connect the smallest fan. It starts, current is 170 milliamps, voltage has dropped by half a volt. Then the second fan and the third, the largest one. All three fans work fine. Together with them, the voltage dropped by almost a volt. Current 600 milliamps, not bad. Now let's see what happens between the voltages plus 5 volts and minus 12. Here it is 16.8 volts. I connect all the fans one by one. The voltage dropped by about 0.3 volts. The current is almost 700 milliamps. The load is about 10 watts, a good result. And finally 24 volts. I use two resistors as a load. Current 470 milliamps, the voltage dropped by about half a volt. I will try to connect the second one. Current 940 milliamps. The voltage dropped to 23 volts. But you can't keep it like this for long, since the minus 12 volt line is designed for only half an ampere. The voltage here sags very little. The main thing is not to exceed the current characteristics of this line. But if you really want to, then the minus 12 volt line can be made much more powerful. You can remove more than 10 amps from it. Such a converted power supply with a 2-pole voltage can be used to power some audio amplifier. Well, if you do not need a 2-pole voltage, but need 24 volts, then the converted minus 12 volt line and the plus 12 line can also be used together and get a very powerful power supply, from which you can take 10 amps 24 volts. I talked about this in one of the previous videos. Just in case, the link will be in the description. As you already understood, it will not be possible to remove large currents from these non-standard voltages. On the minus 5 and minus 12 volt lines it is clear anyway. There are weak diodes, small capacity capacitors and chokes wound with thin wire. It is not advisable to load these lines with more than half an ampere. The same will apply to the voltages that we will receive using these lines. The power supply is designed in such a way that it works normally only when only standard lines are loaded. But when you start loading non-standard voltages, the voltage either drops significantly, or the power supply turns off. Therefore, it will not be possible to extract more than 1 ampere from all these voltages, and somewhere it will be even less. Yes, these lines are not as powerful as we would like. You cannot get a large current from them. But often we do not need high power in everyday life. There are such non-standard cases when you need to turn on an old radio, charge a razor or just turn on table scales. Well, the voltage of 24 volts can be used for some weak LED strips, or for a 24-volt fan. If there is nothing else at hand, then a computer power supply can help here. That's all for today. Put likes, subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed yet. Ask questions in the comments if someone doesn't understand something, and bye everyone.